This book owes a great debt to the French writer Arthur Rimbaud, famous for having written a sonnet called the Voyelles, in which he describes the colors of the vowels, enumerating all of the hallucinations produced by these emotional linchpins of language. The book, Eunoia, has been reproduced now in an upgraded edition for the American audience and includes some translations of this sonnet, Voyelles, by Arthur Rimbaud. I'd like to begin by reading the poem in the original French. I do apologize to my bilingual compatriots for my bolderizations of their very beautiful language. This is Voyelles. Ah, noir, bleu, blanc, I, rouge, ou, vert, eau, bleu, voyelle. Je dirai quelques jours en essence latente. Ah, noir brossé de nu des mûches sécrétantes qui bombine autour des pointures cruelles, golfe d'ombre. Candeur des vapeurs et des tentes, lance des glaciers fiers, noir, blanc, frisson, tombelle. I, peuple, sang craché, rire des lèvres belles dans la couleur usivresse pénitente. E, cycle, librement divin des mers verrides, pays du petit sommet d'animaux, pays des rides que l'alchimie imprime au grand front studieux. O, suprême clairon plein d'esprits deux étranges, silence traversé des mondes et des anges. O, l'oméga, rayon violet de ses yeux. Now this poem is very famously difficult to translate. Here is my normative translation of the poem, which preserves the original measure and meaning. Vowels. A, black, E, white, I, red, U, green, O, blue, the vowels. I will tell thee one day of thy newborn portents. A, the black velvet cuirass of flies whose essence commingles a buzz around the cruelest of smells, wells of shadow. E, the whitewash of mists and tents, glaives of icebergs, albino kings, frostbit fennels. I, the bruises, the blood spat from lips of damsels who must laugh in scorn or shame, both intoxicants. You, the waves, divine vibratos of verdant seas, pleasant meadows rich with venery, grins of ease which alchemy grants the visages of the wise. Oh, the supreme trumpeter of our strange sonnet, quietudes crossed by another world and spirit. Oh, the omega, the violet ray gun of her eyes. Now, I've also translated the poem using a different method. I've translated the sonnet into English, but have preserved exactly the same sequence of vowels used by Arthur Rimbaud in his original sonnet. So all I've done is taken his exact set of vowels, preserved the exact same sequence, and simply replaced all the consonants and punctuations and spaces. But you are hearing exactly the same sequence of vowels. This work is entitled Phonemes. Phantoms infernal without refuge or return, phonemes. We will hark if such resurgent souls ordain a dreamt verse. A, offspring of perfect murders, so unseen that stranglers fulfill no crime, and thus mourners must call the unjust schemes overdoses. E, charmed slumber that engulfs the sleepers, cradled by dreamlike sirens who sing mankind forlorn themes. I, corrupted archangel, shriven when mercy redeems all shadowy specters who plunder shipwrecked believers. You, the sphinx beheld by disciples, then by infidels, a riddle that grieves a king, a truth that crippled minstrels must bewail in epics, like staunch martyrs whom furies spurn. O, untempted saint, who lends this typewritten utterance its fervency, an endless cycle of perseverance. Oh, how the bards abolish symbols when the letters burn. And finally, this translation of the sonnet Voyelles by Arthur Rimbaud. In this case, I've taken exactly the same set of letters used in the original sonnet and merely permuted them like an anagram into a new sonnet. So you've actually heard all of these letters before, just not in this order. This is entitled Vocables. Eternal, you beguile love or ruin, vocables. Jejun vassals quote 10 codas in reliquaries. A, the ceaseless verses at occult monasteries, requiems of dust bound to nebulous particles, embers of gold. E, graven urns in sanctuaries, brass bells unsold, decreed priceless for our canticles. I, a senseless verse, a spell garbled in pentacles, choruses deemed perverse in desolate nurseries. You, a universe expressed as a murmur of tides, all its perplexing maxims, exquisite suicides, dim minds transcended by vivid hexatic prisms. Oh, a vesper stressing serenades or solitudes, a clever muse to generate endless interludes. Oh, my elegiac ode ends in paroxysms.